Myself Rohini Mirgu, talking about vector transformation. This is vector transformation part 1. Here we'll be transforming the vector from one coordinate system to another coordinate system. In part 1, I'll be discussing the vector transformation from Cartesian to cylindrical. Learning outcomes: at the end of this video, you will be able to transform the vector defined in Cartesian coordinate system to the vector in cylindrical coordinate system and vice versa. So, relation between Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate systems, before we move to the actual coordinate system convergence, the vector transformation, let us just recall the relation. What is the relation between Cartesian and cylindrical coordinates? The relation is like this. The cylindrical to Cartesian, if I know the cylindrical coordinates, which are rho phi z, if I want to convert it to Cartesian, the relation is like this: x is equal to rho cos phi, y is equal to rho sin phi, z is same as z. And if I know the coordinates of Cartesian, like x, y, z, how I can find the cylindrical? That is, rho is equal to under root of x square plus y square. As you can see, if I square and add these two, I'll get the value of rho. And if I divide y with x, I get tan phi, and phi is tan inverse of y by x. Z is remaining same. Now let us look for vector transformation, Cartesian to cylindrical. What does it mean? It means that I have some given vector a bar, which is ax, ax bar plus ay, ay bar plus az, az bar. So this bar is nothing but the unit vectors, fine. What this capital means? This capital means the values, like the vector, if I say 3 ax bar, 2 ay bar and 5 az bar, that 3, 2, 5 are this capital values, ax, capital ay, capital az. If I want to transform this vector in the vector of this form, a bar is a rho bar plus a phi bar plus az, az bar, this is my required vector. Then how I can do? So how I can proceed? So when I am finding out for a rho, I should multiply this given vector with the unit vector a rho bar. Then I can put this given vector, which is ax, a rho, a phi, I need to find out. Out of that, I am first finding out a rho, which is a bar dot a rho bar. And a rho bar, I can write like this, which is the given vector ax, ax bar plus ay, ay bar plus az, az bar dot product with a rho bar. Now, when I simplify this, or I simplify this bracket, and I can write ax, ax dot a rho, ay, ay dot a rho plus az, az dot a rho. I know ax dot ax is 1, I know ax dot ay is 0, I know ax dot az is 0. But I do not know the dot product of the unit vectors in different coordinate systems. I do not know the dot product of ax with a rho. So for that, we'll follow this table. This is the table of dot product of unit vectors in cylindrical and Cartesian coordinate systems. So this table is, on one side you can see ax, ay, az. On other side you can see the unit vectors in cylindrical a rho, a phi, az. If I want the dot product of ax with a rho, ax dot a rho is cos phi. If I want ax dot a phi, it is minus sin phi. Likewise I can take. So let us take this equation. A rho is ax, ax dot a rho plus ay, ay dot a rho plus az, az dot a rho. This is the previous slide equation I have written as it is. Now let us find out what is ax dot a rho in the slide. So ax dot a rho is nothing but cos phi, isn't it? Ax dot a rho is cos phi. So I can put it here. Then I want to find out ay dot a rho. So ay dot a rho, I can locate here. Ay dot a rho is sin phi. I can put it here. Similarly, I want az dot a rho. So if I locate, it is giving me the value 0. I can put. So I got the a rho, which is the part of my result vector, is ax cos phi plus ay sin phi. And once I know these values of phi and ax, ay, I can find out the actual value of this a rho. I'll show that solution of one problem as well in this video. Now, once I have calculated a rho, let us find out a phi. A phi is a bar dot a phi. So again, I put this, what is a bar? A bar is the given unit given vector dot product with the unit vector a phi bar. If I simplify, I get this equation. Now, my task is to find out this ax.a5, ay.a5 and az.a5. So, refer this a5 column. In this a5 column, take the values minus sine phi, cos phi and 0 depending on what is written out here. So, when I put these values, I get the equation of a5 as minus ax sine phi plus ay cos phi. No need to remember these equations. You have to follow the procedure. Just remember that table 1. And az is as it is, az is not going to change because z axis in Cartesian as well as cylindrical means same. Now, if I want to find this vector transformation, I need to find out this ax, ay, az. Now, I am doing reverse. This is cylindrical to Cartesian. Given to me is a cylindrical coordinate system and I am trying to find out in Cartesian. So, this is my required vector. Unknowns are ax, ay, az. So, ax can be written as a bar dot ax bar. On both sides, there should be ax. Okay. So, ax is how I can do is I can proceed further like this. Ax is equal to the given vector dot product with the unit vector ax bar. I can simplify. Again, I don't know the dot product directly of the different coordinate systems. So, I should refer table 1 again. So, I refer the table 1 and then the same equation I have repeated here. I can find this dot product arrow dot ax. I can locate arrow dot ax. Yes, arrow dot ax I have located. It is cos phi. I substitute it here. Then I can find out the a5 dot ax. I can locate a5 dot ax in the table. a5 dot ax is this one minus sine phi. So, I can substitute it here. Similarly, I can locate az dot ax, which will be az dot ax is this term, and I can get this equation as ax is a rho cos phi minus a phi sin phi. Similarly, I can find out ay. So, when I am trying to find out for ay, a bar dot ay. So, dot product with ay of the given vector. Now, given vector is in cylindrical. So, I can simplify a rho dot ay. I can refer this rho. A rho dot ay is sin phi. No, then a5 dot ay is a5 dot ay is cos phi, az dot a5 is 0. So, I get a5 as a rho sin phi plus a5 cos phi and az is as it is. So, likewise, I can again prove it here, like in the az column, if you refer az dot az is 1, with others it is showing 0. So, az is as it is. So, vector transformation, an example is shown to understand how to work out with this. Transform given vector a bar, which is 2ax bar plus 3ay plus 5az at point 2, 3, 5 to cylindrical coordinate system. So, a rho is a bar dot a rho. I need to find out in cylindrical. So, I should find out a rho, a5 and az. So, a rho is given vector dot a rho. Given vector is this one, right? Dot product with a rho. Then refer the table 1 for getting this dot products. So, I can find out this values and I can put it here cos phi, sin phi and 0. Now, this cos phi, sin phi, I want to substitute these values. From where I can get? Some point is given to me as 2, 3, 5. From this point and by knowing the equations, I can find out phi as tan inverse y by x. In my point, the y is 3 and x is 2. So, it comes to be 56.3. I can substitute this value in this above equation and I can put these values and I get a rho as 3.6 and then I can find out a5 as well, a bar dot a5. Again, I put given vector dot a5. I can simplify the equation. I can get the values of this ax dot a5, ay dot a5 and so on from this a5 column, like minus sin phi, cos phi and 0. Again, phi already I have calculated as 56.3. I can put it here. I can calculate its value. I am getting 6.25 into 10 raised to minus 4. And az is as it is. Az in the equation is 5. So, az is 5. So, finally, I can say that I have transformed the vector a bar, which is 2ax bar plus 3ay bar plus 5az bar as equal to 3.6 a rho bar plus 6.25 into 10 raised to minus 4a5 bar plus 5 az bar. So, this is how the vector transformation works. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you.